A Philippine lawmaker believes it's the greater good that will be served by his proposal to make COVID-19 vaccinations mandatory. Cavite Representative Elpidio Barzaga Jr. says his idea is not unusual since compulsory vaccination laws have been passed in other countries like the U.S. Barzaga also rejects concerns that compulsory inoculations violate an individual's freedom of choice.
Our personal freedom are not absolute. They could be restricted under exceptional circumstances. At accepted na naman natin na yung karapatang pantao ng isang individual mas kinikilala ng pamahalaan o ng gobyerno ang pangkalahatang karapatan ng mga nakakarami sa ating lipunan. That has been always the policy.
Barzaga's House bill proposes three mandatory COVID-19 vaccinations at any government hospital or health center. The bill exempts persons with medical conditions certified by the health department or a licensed medical doctor. The Philippines is asking other countries, particularly the United States and Israel, for access to their unused COVID-19 vaccines from AstraZeneca. That's according to Vaccine Chief Carlito Galvez Jr. He says Philippine Ambassador to the U.S. Jose Manuel Romualdez is in talks with American officials as the U.S. prepares to release up to 60 million doses of the British-made vaccine globally. Galvez adds Health Secretary Francisco Duque III wrote to Israel about its unused vaccines after the Middle Eastern country said it would no longer need its pending AstraZeneca vaccine deliveries.
Sa ngayon lang talaga, Mr. President, hirap po talaga tayo sa ano, sa ating volume sa first quarter at second quarter. Talagang gipit na gipit tayo.
Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte has approved the extension of the second most stringent quarantine level over Metro Manila and four neighboring provinces. The modified enhanced community quarantine, or MECQ, will stay on until May 14th. Duterte also placed Santiago City in Quirino and the province of Abra under MECQ. Baguio City, Cagayan, Batangas, Davao City, and several other areas will be under general community quarantine, while the rest of the country remains under the loosest lockdown mode, modified general community quarantine. Duterte said in making his decision, he followed the suggestion of medical experts, including Health Secretary Francisco Duque III.
Mga kababayan ko, naghihingi lang ako sa inyo ng paumanhin. I'm sorry that I have to impose longer itong modified enhanced community kasi kailangan nag-spike, may spike ang ano, tumaas yung infections at yung hospital natin puno. Kaya ho nga sana wang inyong dagdagan. Alam ko na galit kayo, magalit na lang kayo sa akin kasi wala man talaga akong magawa. Iyang virus na yan, lumilipad yan sa hangin.
The Philippines' coronavirus death toll has surpassed 17,000. That's after 115 new fatalities were reported on Wednesday. Health officials also announced over 6,800 new COVID-19 cases. They explained the relatively low number was due to the low testing output of laboratories. Recoveries, meanwhile, rose by more than 10,000.